Hey everyone, this is Nick. I wanted to jump on and talk a little bit about custom placeholders inside of your slide layouts. Now, this is a nice custom layout that I've created, very clean, very slick. You have a nice title right here, you have a place for some little text bullets, and then you have a nice full bleed photo image that spans the entire slide. This is what this looks like in the blank layout, the blank slide layout view. When you go to the new slide layout right here, or the new slide menu right here, you get all the different options for your stock template layouts that have those text and photo placeholders. I've created a custom layout that looks just like this. So now, anytime I insert this new slide, I know that I'm going to have a place for a title. I formatted the font and the size really intentionally. And then also I have a place for this bulleted text, just a few little bullet points, and then a nice full photo that I'm going to insert into this placeholder. Now, I was in a training the other day and the instructor said, never delete a placeholder from a slide in normal view. Now, I don't think that's exactly the truth. Now, there is some truth to not deleting placeholders from slides in the master view and not deleting placeholders from those stock layouts. That can have problems later if you're using things like Copilot or Designer. But if you are on a normal view slide like this in editing mode and you happen to delete a placeholder, you don't have to recreate that slide or insert a new slide. You can actually just go up to the Home tab under the Slides menu and click on this little Reset button. The Reset button resets a slide to its normal factory settings, if you will. So you're gonna go ahead and reset that slide and now all the placeholders come back into view. Now, if you had a situation where you were sending out your slide deck and people started, you created the slides, but then other people started formatting and reformatting things like this, so maybe you had that same slide, but over time, somebody decided that they didn't want that image to be the entire height of the slide. They wanted it to be this tiny little image here in the middle, and you get the slide back and say, no, I want this to change back to the original factory settings that I intended for it to have. All you need to do is go back up to that Home tab, click on the Reset button, and now, since that photo is inside that placeholder, it will resize to the intended settings that you had it there. Now that works for slides, that works for things with photos that you have put into those placeholders. If that was a photo that I manually inserted outside of the placeholder, then nothing would happen to that photo. I'll show you an example of that in just a second. But I wanted to also show you the same thing goes for text. You don't have to copy and paste text into placeholders if for some reason the text has kind of gotten funky. So the same thing, I might have shipped this PowerPoint slide off to my coworker and they decided that they wanted everything to be Comic Sans instead of what we intended it for it to be. But now that I'm back, I want it to be brand aligned. I don't want Comic Sans, and I want these to be a bullet point list. Now, I probably wouldn't want to have a bullet point list in my slides anyway, but just for purposes of this demonstration, the placeholder was formatted so that we would have a nice custom blue bullet point in that text box. So again, all I have to do is go to that slide menu, click on the Reset button, and both my title and my text that are now Comic Sans will return back to factory setting. Just go up and click on that Reset button, and that's how you can return everything on your slide to those original placeholder settings. So this is what that blank slide looks like. Now, the thing is, I wanted to show you here, I'm going to duplicate this one slide just to show you. So these things are all filling placeholders, the title, text, and also the picture placeholder. But what if I decided to change this and then maybe I wanted to insert a new photo. I'm going to insert a photo from the stock images. Let's go ahead and search. Once this pops up, we'll search for theme park and see what we get. We have this carousel image and kind of the screaming kid. So what if I put this here? It's going to populate, it's going to appear onto my slide, and then maybe I'm just going to go ahead and put that right there. Maybe I wanted to do a little bit of text, so I'm going to add a manual text box right here, and we'll just do some placeholder text here, just like this. We'll delete that, and I put that right here on my slide. So maybe I'm just starting to sort of redesign this slide just a little bit outside of the placeholders that I've intended for it to happen. Now, when I go back and reset this slide, the things that I've added to the slide manually outside of the placeholders, they're gonna stay put. They're gonna stay in place because PowerPoint doesn't know where to put them. But the things that populate inside of placeholders will return to those factory settings. So let's actually just tick this down, the text really way down in terms of size, just so you can see some of that change too. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go up here, click on the Reset button, and now the text has changed back to factory settings. The photo that was in the placeholder has changed to that full bleed photo. That's factory settings, but you can see the photo that I added right here and the text box right here, those didn't do anything because those I added manually to the slide. So that's one of the reasons why it's really important to have a nicely defined template on the back end so that you have a really nice, clean slide design. Now, if you're the only one working in these slides and you don't have to collaborate, then you can go ahead and kind of just choose blank slide layouts and do whatever you want to. But if you're working in a team setting or you're working in a setting where everybody's going to be collaborating or you're going to be helping people create presentations, it's really, really nice to have some of these different kinds of layouts defined on the back end so you have a nice variety of different slide designs. So I hope that you like this video. Remember, you don't have to insert a new slide to get those placeholders back. You can delete all the placeholders if you want to on that normal view and just go ahead and click on reset, and all of your placeholders will appear back on that slide. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.